Joining us now is Republican, Wisconsin Republican Senator Ron Johnson. Good to see you, sir. I saw you yesterday on one of the Fox shows, and you're none too happy. Give us your reaction to what happened yesterday in the breakdown.
Well, I heard the president earlier saying that it was just very hard to believe that these talks wouldn't go forward. I think what I find hard to believe is that the president wouldn't even get engaged in these talks until a couple weeks ago, that he wouldn't put forward a serious budget. I find it hard to believe that the Senate hasn't passed a budget in over 2 years, and I find it very hard to believe that the Senate wouldn't even allow debate on what I think is probably the solution to the problem, which is really the cut, cap, and balance bill that would actually cut spending next year, cap the growth in spending over 10 years, increase the debt ceiling, but only in connection with passing a constitutional amendment that would actually balance our budget, which, by the way, the American people support by a rate of 74%.
We had Senator Mike Lee on a little bit earlier today. We were talking about the CCB deal, and he said, deal's not dead. You said that yesterday as well. Have you changed your mind at all in the last 24 hours?
No, I think we need to present that to the American people. Let the American people see what our plan is. Let's face it, Juliet. The president has absolutely no credibility in this debate at all, in these negotiations. I don't think he's negotiating in good faith because he's never put anything in writing. I haven't seen it. I've seen reports leaked in the press, that supposedly everything's on the table, that, he's looking at restructuring entitlements. Well, show me the numbers.
Has Boehner seen this information?
Possibly, but the American people haven't seen it, and that's just not the way this should at all occur. The Democrats should have put forward a budget 2 years ago on April 15th. They certainly should have put forward one on April 15th of this year so the American people can see what their solution to the problem is. All the American people have seen is solutions from the Republican side. And to give, every time we've negotiated with this president, unfortunately, our good faith efforts have given him credibility when he has no credibility. And that's been a real shame.
You feel like this should be opened up. It should be a lot more translucent, this whole process.
Absolutely. This is crazy to think that you can negotiate a $3.7 trillion a year budget. Another way of putting that is $3.7 million. That's how large the federal government is. And you're going to have a couple individuals negotiating for a couple of weeks and trying to decide the future fate of America. That is absurd.
All right,
it's crazy.
Let's talk about your state and what your state is doing right. Based on total employment figures, Wisconsin created more than half of total U.S. jobs in June. How did this happen? Mm-hmm. Explain.
Well, it's amazing what happens when you actually create an attractive environment for business and job creation. When you actually tell businesses, we want you to locate in our state or want you to locate in our country. And it's also amazing when politicians actually, or elected officials, actually do what they said they were going to do when they ran for election. Actually step up the plate, have the political will, make the hard choices to actually fix a problem. Wisconsin was dealing with a $1.8 billion a year budget deficit. The federal government, we're dealing with about a $1.65 trillion. It's almost 1,000 times worse because there's no limitation. There's no constitutional requirement to balance your budget. That's what would be the solution for America's problems. Follow the example of Wisconsin. You'll see the same type of job growth if we do.
Senator Ron Johnson, thanks very much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me on.